Welcome guys to the next episode of the series of Core Java, and we were discussing the topic of exceptions and we've reached till nested try. So the next exception is your next topic to be covered is user defined exception. Now we all know what is user defined and built in. There are always two types of terminologies used in any programming language. One is built in and other is user defined. So we had the built in exceptions. So these are your built-in exceptions which we have studied. So along with that, you can create your own exceptions also. The programmer can write his own exceptions. That is called as user defined exception. So we will be writing a program. Let's say we are a factory or we are a wholesaler and we deal in the selling of markers, let's say whiteboard markers or whatever. We deal in whiteboard markers, we are wholesalers, not retailers. So if someone comes up to me and says, I want to buy a single marker, I will say, no, sir, not possible. We don't sell in retail. Minimum, you have to order 500 pieces. Then only we can accept your order, else the order will be rejected by our system. Our software will not accept the order. The order should be 500 and above. How much? Should be 500 and above. So I will create my own exception. So if someone enters quantity as 400, I will throw an exception saying low quantity. The quantity is very low for the system to accept it. And if someone enters quantity more than 500, 550, I will display order accepted. So like this, I will create my own exception that will be low, and we will follow the terminologies which the built-in function, built-in exceptions used will always end it with exception. So I will create my own exception saying low quantity exception, which will be triggered, which will be thrown when the quantity entered by the user is less than 500. So I will create my own exception, low quantity exception. Clear? All the exceptions, they inherit from which class? We had discussed this in the first episode of exception handling. The parent class for all the exceptions, the grandparent is throwable. Which class is the grandparent class? The throwable class. Then from the throwable, which class inherits? Exception class. And from exception, all these exceptions inherit from the exception class. So all the built-in exceptions inherit from the exception class. So my user defined exception should also inherit from the exception class. So whatever my user defined exceptions are, so in this case I am making exception by the name low quantity exception, that too should inherit from which class? Exception class. So let's create an exception. Simple. So I will write a code. So I'll create a class and I'll give it my own exception as it is user defined exception. So I'll give the name as low quantity exception. And this class should compulsory inherit from. So inheritance is extends keyword, extends from the exception class. So we'll do the topic of inheritance later on. Maybe the next topic should be inheritance after exceptions. So how do you inherit? Using the extends plural, it's plural form, extends. And from which class are we extending? Exception. And now here in the class, I will create my error message, which we have to show. The error message which we have to show. What error message we have to show? Please order 500 quantity or please order minimum. So this exception, error message which we will show to the user. This is a string. So this I am taking over here in the class. So string error message, and let's write a constructor which will initialize this variable for us. So I am writing a constructor public low quantity exception, and I will pass, this will be a parameterized constructor. So I will, while creating the object, I will pass this string while creating the object. So that should go in the constructor. So I will take a string A, and where should this A be stored into? Correct, this A should go in the error message. Okay, and now if I want to return this, I will just override the to string function. What will the to string function do? Public string to string, it will return me the error message. So it will return me a string. The to string function will return me a string, which is the only string we have in this class. Perfect. So we'll return you the error message. Done. This class has been done. This is job has been done. We have written the exception class. Okay. Now let's write a class which will accept the quantity. So class, what do you call it as? What is the topic? User defined exception, no? So user defined exception. And what will this class contain? This will contain public static void main string args . So I hope till here the program is pretty clear. It's self-explanatory. This class which I have created, the exception class, has to compulsory extend from the exception class and has only one variable, that is a string error message, and it has a constructor which will initialize the error message. It has a to string function which will return the error message. Simple. This pattern you need to follow for all your user defined exceptions. Okay. Now over here I need to accept the quantity. So I'll take the variable as integer quantity. As I need to accept from the user, I'll be using scanner. So let's import it. Import java.util.star. And so here I'll be creating the scanner variable. Scanner sc equals to new scanner system.in. And I'll prompt the user now. System.out.println. What? Please enter order quantity. Now, whatever he enters, I'll scan that. So, I will scan it and put it in which variable? The quantity variable. Now I want you to focus over here. We are doing which exception? User defined exception or predefined exception? Yes, we all know we are doing user defined exception. So all the burden is at the user's end. Because if you observe what was the natural behavior of Java, so this natural tendency is for your built-in. Is because it does it automatically for the built-in. This natural tendency is for the inbuilt variable, inbuilt, built-in, or predefined, whatever you call it. For the built-in exceptions, it is done by the JRE, the Java Runtime Environment. It will identify which exception class the exception belongs to. It will create object of that exception class and it will throw the object. Who is the it? The JRE. But now as we are doing user defined exception, we have to do all these three activities. We have to identify, we mean the programmer has to identify which class the exception is. The programmer needs to create the object and the programmer has to throw the object. This all in the user defined case has to be done by the programmer, because we are doing user defined function. So let's come back over here. So quantity, so this is the area which is notorious. What if he enters quantity as 300 200, though that might lead to a problem. So what I'll try to do is I'll try to put this code in the try catch. I will try to put this code in the try catch. So I'll be trying this code. Now what if my doubt, which I had, exceptions are, it may occur, right? Or it may not occur. So if I was having a gut feeling that this might throw an exception, and if it, so I'll just check it. So if the quantity is less than 500, if this happens, then what to do? Then who has to create the object? So we have to identify, so which class exception will occur. So if the quantity is less than 500, the exception which will occur is low quantity exception. Identified, very good. Next, create the object. Create the object. So who has to create the object? The programmer has to create the object. So if the quantity is less than 500, then object of which class to be created? New, low quantity exception. And while creating the object, what does the constructor demand? It demands a string. And what is that string? That string is the error message. So I'll copy the error message over here. So while creating the object of this, I will pass this string as an error message. I will pass this, and then I just have to use one. And the third last part is what we have to do. Throw. So I just have to add the keyword over here. Throw. So this is how you throw a user defined exception. So once we have got the quantity, and we were thinking that this quantity will be notorious, so I have put that quantity part in the try block. So if my doubt, which I had that the user might enter less than 500, is true, what we have to do? We have to throw an object of the low quantity exception. Clear? And if it is correct, then we will say else. What will we say? Else we will say order accepted. Simple as that. So this was the line which we were feeling might be notorious. So we will just check that line. So if the quantity is less than 500, identify which exception, create its object. How do we create object in Java? Therefore, new keyword, and then throw that. And that class constructor wanted a string as an argument, so I have given the string over here. That string is my error message. And now this try closes. Now immediately after the try, what follows? The catch follows. So catch will be caught by which exception will catch it now? The low quantity exception. And LQE, whatever name you can give, ABCXYZ. And what do we need to display to the user? System.out.println. I'll just print the object. Who will convert the object to string for me? The toString function of this class. More or less, we are done. Irrespective of shop or not, if I visit the store, you will always greet me while going. Finally does not have any braces. Finally does not have any brackets. So you will always greet me irrespective I buy or no. Clear? And the finally also is closed. This is for the main. and this is for the class. The main clause is class clauses. Am I understood, guys? I'll just try to fit this into one frame if possible. So here you go. So I have created my user defined exception. Then a class, this class contains main, so this class should be public, right? And the program will be saved by this. So let's save the program first. Exception, user defined exception dot java. So void main, integer quantity scanner variable, enter the quantity. Now this part, the quantity part is a bit notorious, so I have put that into try. If the quantity is less than 500, so on what condition will the exception be thrown? So this is the condition for throwing the exception. If it is less than 500, throw new low quantity exception, else you say it's order accepted. So if the exception is thrown, what sort of exception it is? Low quantity. So we will catch it, low quantity exception LQE, the object, and I'll display the LQE. Clear? And finally will always be displayed. Let's save it. Let's try to run it. CMD Java C. What was the exception name? What was the class name? UserDef. Class compiles perfectly. And now let's run. So if I enter quantity as 900, what should it show? Order accepted, thank you, visit again. And if I enter quantity as 300, it will say, please order 500 minimum quantity or above, thank you, visit again. Clear? I'll upload this program in the description and you can practice it from there. Thank you, guys.